Welcome to Master Chem Academy. Today our present session, carboxylic acids. A new topic, carboxylic acids, question and answers. So in this first one, oxidation of primary alcohols finally give. So we know that what are primary alcohols. So example CH3, CH2OH. This is primary alcohol. Primary alcohols on oxidation in presence of KMnO4 or K2Cr2O7 undergoes readily in presence of KMnO4 or K2S2SO4Cr2O7 H+, means acidic KMnO4 or acidic K2Cr2O7, even neutral medium KMnO4 or K2Cr2O7 converts alcohol into corresponding aldehyde. Okay, what is this? This is ethyl alcohol and this one is acetaldehyde. This acetaldehyde again undergoes oxidation in presence of same KMnO4 or K2Cr2O7 acidic conditions, converts into carboxylic acid CH3COOH. What is this? This is acetic acid. Okay, so what is our answer? This should be option C, carboxylic acid. Finally give. Okay. So first it gives aldehyde. Later on oxidation, they readily, easily converts aldehyde to, conversion takes place from aldehyde to alcohol, carboxylic acid in presence of KMnO4 or K2Cr2O7 acidic condition. So answer should be carboxylic acids. Okay, move on to next question. Okay, next one, second one, oxidation of isopropyl alcohol finally give. Okay, what is isopropyl alcohol? So it's a secondary alcohol, CH3COOH CH3. This is called isopropyl alcohol. Isopropyl alcohol on oxidation, generally alcohols oxidation takes place in presence of KMnO4 or K2Cr2O7 H+, acidic condition. So how it converts into corresponding ketone. Okay, in a previous question, so what is that? Let's say now it is secondary alcohol. You see, it is primary alcohol, CH3CH2OH. It is a primary alcohol. Primary alcohols on oxidation, so what it gives? CH3CHO aldehyde, which on oxidation, so gives CH3COOH. So consider this, how many carbon atoms are there? Two carbon atoms. Here, two carbon atoms. Here, two carbon atoms. Okay, two carbons alcohol given, two carbon carboxylic acid. Now here it is aldehyde, now it is ketone. What is that? Acetone. Now this acetone undergoes oxidation under similar conditions. So what it gives? CH3COOH. Breakage of this bond takes place. CH3COOH plus HCOOH. What is this? Acetic acid, formic acid. Okay? Acetic acid and formic acid both are formed. So, by the oxidation of acetone. So, what happened here? Three carbons ketone. Ketone having three carbons. So, but here one is having two carbons and one is having one carbon atom. Okay? Two carbon carboxylic acid is acetic acid and one carbon carboxylic acid is formic acid. So, what is your answer? C. Okay? By primary alcohol, same number of carbons carboxylic acid is formed. But secondary alcohols gives two carboxylic acid. So one is one with two carbons and one is one carbon. So in case of isopropyl alcohol. Okay, this is about oxidation of alcohols. So as a whole, what is our conclusion? So primary alcohols gives aldehyde first. So and secondary alcohols gives ketone. Okay, so later on both gives carboxylic acids. Okay, next move on to third question. Okay, next third question. So what is this? CH3MgBr, alkyl magnesium halide. So this RMgX, we know that RMgX, what is it? This is Grignard reagent. So Grignard reagents with the CO2 in presence of dry ether followed by hydrolysis. So what happens? So first CH3MgBr plus CO2. So CO2. So due to this electronegativity, oxygen gets negative charge, carbon gets positive charge. So here carbon part negative charge and metallic part gets positive charge. Now positive part towards negative center and a negative part towards positive center. Now what it gives? So that is C double bond O remains same, and here at positive center CH3 and at negative center OMgBr. This is the intermediate compound, and now this undergoes hydrolysis. This undergoes hydrolysis. How it is? So in this manner, HOH. So what it gives? CH3COOH. So CH3COOH plus MgOHBr. Okay. So this is the acetic acid, carboxylic acid, acetic acid. So what is your answer? Option C. So acetic acid is the correct answer. So this is about so preparation of carboxylic acid from Grignard reagents. So how can you prepare acetic acid from methyl magnesium bromide? So what is the useful here? What is the reagents here? So CO2, carbon dioxide in presence of dry ether and followed by hydrolysis. This condition, reaction conditions are much to convert alkyl magnesium halide to carboxylic acid. Okay, next move on to fourth question. Okay, next fourth question. Ester hydrolysis gives. So acid plus alcohol, acid plus aldehyde. These are the given options. Acid plus ketone and acid plus ether. So in this, so which is the correct answer? So what is ester? So that is RCOOR dash. Okay. So if both R and R are different, then so alcohol undergoes H plus or OH minus. So hydrolysis takes place. What it gives? That gives RCOOH and R dash OH. Okay. Hydrolysis takes place here. HOH. Okay. Oxygen attached alkyl group converts into alcohol. That you should remember. So which is converted to alcohol? So if you take CH3COOC2H5. So hydrolysis takes place. Acidic are basic conditions. So it's also a reversible reaction. So CH3COOH plus C2H5OH. Okay. So it must be. So alcohol must having ethyl group, because oxygen containing alkyl group. Okay, oxygen having alkyl group converts into alcohol. That you should remember here. So what is that here? It is acetic acid and ethyl alcohol. So it is acid and alcohol. So what is the correct answer? Option A is the correct answer. Acid plus alcohol is formed by ester hydrolysis. Once ester undergoes hydrolysis, acid it cuts into acid and ethyl alcohol. Okay. This one, if in presence of KOH, okay, heating, what it gives? CH3COOK plus C2H5OH. This CH3COOK undergoes in presence of H plus, okay, plus HCl. What it gives? CH3COOH plus HCl. This is known as saponification. What is that? Saponification. What is saponification? Hydrolysis of ester in presence of alkali. Okay, hydrolysis of ester in presence of alkali is known as saponification. This is ester hydrolysis in basic condition, that is alkalic AOH. Okay, this is about ester hydrolysis. So from ester hydrolysis as well, we can prepare alcohols and acids. Okay, so here what is our topic? Carboxylic acid. So main product is an ester ester hydrolysis. What is the main product? Carboxylic acid. Fifth one, amides on hydrolysis gives. What are amides? So we know that RCOOH2. These are called amides. These on hydrolysis. So H3O plus heating. What it gives? RCOOH plus ammonia NH3. Okay, H. RCOOH plus NH3. So what is this? Carboxylic acid and this one ammonia. So that's why option A is the correct answer. Okay, next we'll move on to next sixth one. The sixth one, acid chlorides and acid anhydrides on hydrolysis gives. So it must be carboxylic acid. How it is? Acid chloride. What is acid chloride? RCOCl. So on hydrolysis, H3O plus H plus. So what it gives? RCOOH plus HCl. So undergoes here OHH. Simple. Okay, carboxylic acid and HCl. So main product is carboxylic acid. And what is acid anhydride? Okay, RCOOCOR. This is called acid anhydride. This H3O plus heating. So here hydrolysis takes place, HOH. Here, RCOOH. 2 moles of RCOOH is formed. Okay? So, in two ways, so whether it is acid chloride or anhydride, this is acid chloride, and this is acid anhydride or RCOH2 amide. Okay? All these gives carboxylic acid only, on hydrolysis. Okay? So this is the comparison, amide, acid chloride and acid anhydride, which are hydrolysis gives carboxylic acids. Okay, next move on to seventh one. Next seventh one, so preparation of carboxylic acid, acetic acid with in presence of rhodium or cobalt, okay, so here heating pressure, so what are X and Y? Okay, these are the given options. So what is the answer? It must be CH3CHO plus CO. Okay, CH3CHO plus CO. This is a special method for the preparation of acetic acid. Okay, now in presence of rhodium or cobalt, heating pressure. So what it gives? CH3COOH. Special method for the preparation of acetic acid. So what are the reactants here? Acetaldehyde and carbon monoxide. This is carbon monoxide. This catalyst is cobalt. Okay. So this is about seventh one. Next, move on to eighth question. So that is X plus Y in presence of air and manganese acetate. What is this manganese acetate? What it gives? Acetic acid. This is also special preparation method for acetic acid. So what are X and Y here? So, option A is the correct answer. Okay, CH3OH from alcohols. Alcohol, oxygen, air. So, here manganese acetate, MnOCOCH3 taken twice. So, what it gives? CH3COOH. So, what is the comparison with the previous question, seventh one? So, that is CH3CHO, this option, second. CH3CHO plus carbon monoxide. So, in presence of rhodium or cobalt, so here heating and pressure, what it gives? CH3COOH. These two are the special preparation methods for the preparation of acetic acid. CH3OH here and here, both are acetic acid. So, here alcohol and oxygen, here aldehyde and carbon monoxide. So, this is about 8th one. Next, move on to 9th one. Vinegar is a, so what is your answer? So this is a 6 to 10% aqueous solution of acetic acid. Vinegar is a acetic acid, not a formaldehyde. Okay. So how vinegar is formed? So this is liquor containing 12 to 15% of ethyl alcohol. Liquor containing 12 to 15% of ethyl alcohol undergoes fermentation gives vinegar. What is vinegar? 6 to 10% aqueous solution of acetic acid. 12 to 15% of ethyl alcohol converting into 6 to 10% of acetic acid. Okay, how this fermentation is achieved? So this in presence of bacteria. What is that bacteria? That is Mycoderma aceti. What is the bacteria? Mycoderma aceti. And in presence of air and temperature 30 to 35 degree centigrade. In these conditions, fermentation occurs in presence of this bacteria and converts this into vinegar. Okay, that's why this is also called as acetous fermentation. Okay, in presence of acetic bacteria, fermentation occurs. That's why it is also called as acetous fermentation. This is important question. So you should remember 2 points here. What is the percentage percentage of alcohol present in liquor, and what is the percentage of acetic acid? What is it here? 12 to 15% of ethyl alcohol. Here it is 6 to 10% of aqueous solution of acetic acid. So this is about 9th one. Next move on to 10th one. Okay, next 10th one. Acetonitrile when boiled with alkali or acid gives. So what is your answer? First, what is acetonitrile? That is CH3C triple bond N. This is called acetonitrile. This when boiled with H plus or OH minus alkali or acid. So undergoes hydrolysis. So what it gives? CH3CONH2. CH3 is CO and NH2. What is this? This is amide. Okay. Alkyl cyanide. It is also called as acetonitrile. Undergoes acidic or basic hydrolysis. Gives amide. This amide undergoes again hydrolysis. H plus or OH minus. Hydrolysis. What it gives? CH3COOH plus NH3. So here hydrolysis occurs. OHH. CH3COOH and NH3. So what is your answer? So this third one. Acid and ammonia. Both are formed from acetonitrile. So this is also a preparation method for carboxylic acid from alkyl cyanide to carboxylic acid. How to prepare alkyl cyanide to carboxylic acid? So by acidic or basic hydrolysis. Okay, next move on to 11th one, acetylene. So what is this? Acetylene on hydrolysis in presence of mercury, Hg2+, acidic condition, H2SO4 gives A, which on observation gives B. What are A and B? So this is CH3CHO. What is A? CH3. So CH and H2. CH3CHO. This on oxidation, we know that what it gives? CH3COOH. Acetic acid. Okay. One is acetic acid and one is acetaldehyde. Okay. So this is also one of the preparation method for the acetic acid. How to prepare from acetylene? Acetylene undergoes hydrolysis in presence of Hg2+ and H2SO4. So what it gives? First, aldehyde. Once aldehyde is prepared, it is very easy because it is has more prone to convert into by oxidation into acid. So that's why acetaldehyde converts into acetic acid. So next move on to 12th one. Next 12th one, chloroform. What is chloroform? We know that CHCl3. Okay, so I'm writing CHCl3. This when hydrolyzed with the aqueous solution of alkali. So that is 3KOH minus 3KCl takes place and CHOHOHOH. Okay, trihalogen derivative now converted as trihydroxy derivative. Now whenever two or three OH groups on same carbon, that is unstable, that's why it leads to the formation of carboxylic acid by the elimination of water. Okay, so what it is, HC double bond O OH. Okay, this is the double bond. So C double bond O, carbon is having one hydrogen and OH. So what is this? Formic acid. Formic acid. Okay, so what is the answer? B is the correct answer. So from trihalogen derivatives. Okay, from trihalogen derivatives, we can convert the prime trihalogen derivatives into carboxylic acids. How it is? By aqueous solution of alkali. So first it converts into trihydroxy compound, later on by dehydration it gives carboxylic acid, formic acid. Okay, so now if you want to prepare C6H5COOH, what is this? Benzoic acid. What we should take here? Okay, so what is that? That is C6H5CHCCl3. C6H5CCl3. So this is called benzotrichloride. This benzotrichloride under the same conditions, 3KOH, presence of alkali, minus 3KCl takes place, eliminated. So what it gives? C6H5COOH. Okay, so one of the hydrogen, so minus H2O, C6H5COOH. What is this? This is benzoic acid. Okay, benzoic acid from benzotrichloride, formic acid from chloroform. Okay, so by this trihalogen derivatives as well, we can prepare carboxylic acids. Then next move on to 13th one. Okay, next 13th one, decarboxylation of malonic acid give. So what is meant by decarboxylation? So removal of CO2 is decarboxylation. What is malonic acid? So 3 carbons carboxylic acid is malonic acid. So what is that? CH2COOH. This is called malonic acid. This malonic acid on heating, removal of CO2 takes place. Generally by heating only decarboxylation takes place. So minus CO2, what it gives? H. So this is CH3COOH plus CO2. Okay, CH3COOH plus CO2. So acetic acid and CO2 is formed. So this is also one of the preparation method for the carboxylic acid. Okay, from dicarboxylic acid to conversion of dicarboxylic acid to monocarboxylic acid. So this is dicarboxylic acid. Okay, this is monocarboxylic acid. Okay, now if you want, if it is here, it is COOH and COOH. What is this? Oxalic acid. So this is malonic acid gives, what is the carboxylic acid? That is acetic acid. Now what about oxalic acid? Okay, what is the product? So by heating, loss of CO2 takes place, and that's why what it gives? HCOOH plus CO2. Okay, if it is given carboxylic acid is oxalic acid, what is your answer? HCOOH plus CO2. But what is given here? Malonic acid. That's why acetic acid and CO2. So this is about preparation methods of carboxylic acids. Okay, by question and answers format, I have completed all preparation methods. Okay, all preparation methods of carboxylic acids. So I have covered in this 13 questions. Okay, so preparation methods of carboxylic acid was over.